The fourth bridge, one of engineering's great British achievements and recognisable to people throughout the world. And here we are in Trainsir World 4 with this iconic structure faithfully recreated in the brand new Fife Circle DLC. I'll take a Class 170 on a journey from Edinburgh Waverley to Glenrothes, and for this first run on this line via the west bank of the Firth of Forth. Enjoy the ride. And hello, welcome to Edinburgh Waverley. Well, I said that a couple of weeks ago when we looked at the network Scottish route for Train Simulator, and that was a grand run to Glasgow Queen Street. But it's lovely to see Edinburgh Waverley in Train Sim World 4. Of course, not the first time. We had it in the Edinburgh Glasgow route that came out a little while back from Rivet Games, but you can see the North British Hotel in the background very accurately represented. Now I have to say, I find this really good because it's good to see all the displays with real times, with the actual platforms that they're due to depart from, and that will move along as the day progresses. We have a little gimmick here, because if you move there, go down again. So moving escalators.
Welcome to the ScotRail service to Glenrothes with Thornton. Calling at Haymarket, South Gyle, Edinburgh Gateway, Dalmeny, North Queensferry, Inverkeithing, Rosyth, Dunfermline City, Dunfermline Queen Margaret, Cowdenbeath, Lochgelly, Cardendon, Glenrothes with Thornton. If you see something that doesn't look right, speak to staff or text the British Transport Police on 61016. We'll sort it. See it, say it. Sorted.
Well, good to hear the announcements. I think there's been some comment about them not being absolutely true to perfection, but not the real ones, but it doesn't massively bother me, I must say. It's a Scottish voice, it sounds pretty realistic. Just a relief to get rid of those awful bagpipe sounds, and fair enough. If we got it on a rail tour service and you've got a model of them playing the bagpipes in the background for a couple of minutes, that'd be quite nice. But to have them constantly playing just was not a great idea at all. And whoever came up with that idea hadn't got that right, it has to be said. And I think we can go. We have a class 385. I think with this mod that I've downloaded today from the Train Sim community website, as well as getting rid of the bagpipes, they've improved straight away the ballast textures, which is very nice to see. Is waiting for access to the line that we are on by the looks of things. In fact, we might be heading off towards the right, so it might do an about turn. Yep, we're heading off to the right, so I think the 385 will get clearance into the platform soon. Ah, here we have the first sight of a moving Azuma. It's completely coincidental, I hadn't realised that that was going to happen.
We'll soon arrive at Haymarket. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
Now, there's been a lot of talk about the sounds and not sounding particularly accurate for this 170, but a bit on the quiet side, I would say. Slightly noisy through the tunnels. But I can guarantee you probably within a week there'll be a great upload for it on Trainsome Community. Somebody will be working at it. I'm not saying that's an excuse for not producing great sounds, but I think sometimes expectations are nowadays a little bit overinflated. I think it would have been nice if Rivet Games had perhaps been given another few weeks to finish things off completely. Too cautious with the brakes there, wasn't I? But it's a lovely looking model. It'll be really nice when the 158 comes out in Sultair livery, I'm sure. I know there is already a 158 in Sultair livery on Creators Club. But when the official one comes out, it'll have all the correct interiors and I think a different cab as well, apparently. We've got a few seconds to go before our 0751 departure. I think Easter's made a difference. It's been brought out perhaps a little bit too early before it was ready, but there was a desire to get it out in time for the Easter holidays. It's just been such an exciting few weeks in the world of train sim. Seen the, I'm thinking about the Azuma, we've got the official announcements now on the London King's Cross to Leeds and York route from Alan Thompson Simulation, so that'll be worth giving that a run fairly soon. Past Murrayfield, over Scottish Rugby. Now, I think this mod as well said something about improving the foliage a bit. I don't know exactly how, but I must say it does look a bit better than when I had a little glance at it last night before this mod came out. Confines of the overhead lines on the Glasgow Queen Street route. Also the trains going to Glasgow Central as well would still go this way and would divert away towards Carstairs. There as well. Surely they don't have people creating graffiti in Edinburgh, do they? We are 75 miles an hour. Briefly at least, then we get a 90. But we must be careful of our first stop at South Gyle. Step break.
We'll soon arrive at South Gyle. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
People have been asking about automated announcements for ages. Of course, we didn't quite get it with the original Edinburgh-Glasgow route. It'd be great if that could be implemented now. And that route massively now needs an upgrade to include this 170 and bring that up to scratch. Of course, ironically, I've heard a few people saying, can't you switch the automated announcements off? Well, just to have them in is good, isn't it? So, look at South Gyle. There's a feeling in some ways you kind of think, well, no, I mean that looks a bit bare, doesn't it? But maybe that's how it does look in real life. There is one or two examples throughout the route where it feels a little bit not finished off. That's pretty nice though. I mean, sheds, various things in the gardens. And also, the walkways are all nicely done. Roads are in place, got the fence in there. Recognise those houses from the Kuju Days of Train Sim Classic, though. Trying to be a bit patient with the accelerator, I think there's that tendency to go into full power immediately, and I can't imagine that drivers do that too much in real life. I mean, maybe it doesn't have the glamour of the London Overground route, and I think that was a little bit more polished in truth.
We'll soon arrive at Edinburgh Gateway. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
Makes a difference with the change in the ballast colour than the default. I think Rivet Games have probably rushed a little bit into producing this as well, because they've only just produced the Bernina line, and presumably they must have been working on both for some time, but I don't think they were quite ready to produce this, but the station still looked pretty decent though. I mean, it would have been great to have had the 158 coming out straight away. And implemented into the timetable. Many. Our next stop. It's good to see there we're on a little bit of an upward gradient, and until we some power came into force, we actually started to roll back slightly. some of the scenery in the distance could do with a bit of work on it. Maybe this foliage update has helped a bit today. I don't have the peat forest route, I don't know whether that makes any difference. So we're getting the warning because of the reduction in speed down to 80, but we're not quite up to 80 yet, so it doesn't really matter for us. And then Dalmeny is just before the fourth bridge. Quite nice to drive. It's an improvement on how the 385 came out with the Edinburgh Glasgow route anyway, because that was basically undrivable. I still don't like driving it to this day, waiting for some decent sounds on it.
We'll soon arrive at Dalmeny. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
It's perhaps licensing about using the official announcements. Quite know how this licensing works, because they've obviously had to have permission from ScotRail, and it's been done in conjunction with ScotRail, but there's obviously limitations within that. Good effort, banging into people. I see a good effort with representing the buildings, quite nicely done. And I see it's pretty fair load for the train. It's good to see we're not completely empty. The interior is quite nice. We're about to go over the fourth bridge. You can see it in the distance. It was completed in 1890. Scotland's greatest man-made wonder. It was named in 2016 after a boat designed by Sir John Fowler and Sir Benjamin Barker. Total length 8,094 feet. It was 361 metres above high water. And I'm just trying to give you a few facts before we actually go over it, and I want you to just appreciate it. 50 mile an hour is the speed limit as we go over it. being so excited, I'm speeding.
We'll soon arrive at North Queens Ferry. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
We've had the fourth rail bridge represented in Train Sim Classic before, and that was something to see. It was a sight to behold, but I think it's been done beautifully by Rivet Games in Train Sim World 4. And again, looking at the station here and the buildings around, it's pretty nice. I'm enjoying this run. I kind of thought I wasn't going to enjoy it massively, but I'm really enjoying it. Maybe the stations are a bit too bright in places, not quite weathered. The station's coming pretty thick and fast. It's a faster run if you take the east side of the further forth. There's all sorts of legendary things about the Fourth Bridge, and I think the people who live at North Queens Ferry, I've seen interviews down the years, I'm sure there's one or two on YouTube around, about the residents who live nearby, I'm speeding again, where they've had bits of the Fourth Bridge landing in their garden. And there's also, it's one of those sayings, isn't it, about painting the Fourth Bridge. It's to talk about it being an endless task. You start one end of the bridge, you get to the end, you have to start it all over again. That's how long it takes. Well, that's never been the case. That's a myth.
We'll soon arrive at Inverkeithing. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
I'm liking the effects through the tunnel there. They've got some sort of special paint on the Fourth Bridge nowadays so that it doesn't need painting at all. I like the detail on this station. Here we are at Inverkeithing. Buses over the disabled spaces.
May I have your attention, please? Hold circuit television.
We're a bit behind schedule actually now, a couple of minutes. Feather there pointing to the left indicates that we are taking the west side of the route. It's almost like two routes in one, this, because if you go off to the right, we're off towards Kirkcuddy and Markinch. Of course, eventually to places like Perth or Dundee. But we're going over the west side. Fife is coming up next. Say again, there's no active GMSR. I think actually I should have switched it on at least. It does a little bit. Sure, they'll get that right one day. Cab's pretty nice though. Feels pretty accurate.
We'll soon arrive at Rosyth. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
Try not to forget. Perhaps coming to this a bit too speedy. We're all right though. Brakes are pretty tidy on this thing. Car marker on the left. Be nice when we get to the point where there's announcements actually on the platform as well, and that's surely not impossible either. They've got this far with it. I mean, a slight disappointment that Rivet Games have got this on this route, the announcements, but then they didn't have them Dovetail Games on the Overgrown route. You know, did show off a little sound files that I downloaded on that the other day, and you can kind of put announcements in of a sort, but would have been great if they got the official TFL, London Overground advert announcements included. So Dunfermline City is next. We've got a couple of stations in Dunfermline. Quite a steep uphill gradient, that's why we're not really gaining speed particularly well. And infrastructure on the right. I don't know whether moving traffic's been represented. It certainly was on the Overgrown route. Felt really busy in places there. This feels slightly a downgrade on that, but partly because I think it's not 100% finished. There'll be a patch undoubtedly, I'm sure, from Rivet at some point. We know that they are planning on putting the Leven branch in when it comes out in real life in June, or at least afterwards. We're coming in towards Dunfermline City.
We'll soon arrive at Dunfermline City. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
So we've got a busy dual carriageway down there and nicely put in, but there's no traffic on it. First time seeing this section. I've watched a couple of the streams, but down this part of the route. Station looks nicely done. Thank you. I do like how it, as you move off, how it rolls back on a uphill gradient. That's how it should be. I think there is some sort of way of holding it, a bit like you would with a clutch on a car. I'm not sure the exact technique. Once we've got the proper 158 into the timetable, it's going to look pretty decent, and it's really going to make Edinburgh Waverley look busy with 158s, with 170s, with 385s and zoomers. It's not far off being the full house. The only thing we're not going to see is the ScotRail liveried HSDs. And again, would it be really that much work? I know there's a Creators Club version of it, and I know that they are different. They have the plug doors, and it's not quite the same, but surely they could put something in. I'd like to see a bit more effort on some of the AI, because that really does make it feel realistic. I like the scenery around here though. Just that feeling of being part of a city environment.
We'll soon arrive at Dunfermline Queen Margaret. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
I'm sure there'll be a mod to get rid of the ding 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 ding. Surely it should be just ding. Amazing infrastructure with all the walkways nowadays. Actually, it's connected up with anything. Or is it a pylon? Yeah, it is a pylon. No wires connected it though. But, there's quite a few bungalows around here. Cowdenbeath, Lochgally, Cardendon, and then Glenrothes with Thornton. It certainly, I think that this is a lot better, more enjoyable route than the, for instance, the West Cornwall line. I mean, I quite enjoy doing the St Erth to St Ives bit of that line. It's quite a roller coaster and difficult to control, but the bit from Penzance, yeah, it's lovely coming out. You can see St Michael's Mount, first bit of the scenery, but then when you go inland, and it's quite slow as well, it feels, it's never really found it a great delight. Feels like a pointless journey as well. It doesn't really go to anywhere. If it went to Plymouth, then that would be a meaningful route. But at least this run to Glenrothes with Thornton feels like a meaningful run, and it's a proper end-to-end run as well. And okay, Mark Kinch isn't really on the other side, but it's probably a practical place to end it. They've certainly got the full five circle represented. There's already other versions of this Class 170 on Creators Club with the cross-country version and the northern version, the southern version as well, which is that supposed to be a 172? Not totally sure about that. Certainly the overground one is supposed to be a 172. And okay, I know it's the wrong era and completely different, but you could do a 172 on the Goblin line. I suppose, to be fair, you could do a run just as it was just before electrification kicked in. I'm sure there must have been a period when that existed. The lines, the wires were up, but they were still running the diesel trains. Downhill now, you can feel accelerating away much, much better.
We'll soon arrive at Cowden and Beef. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
With the cross country one, you'll be able to do a run straight away from Nottingham to Derby on the Nottingham Cardiff runs. something that looks a bit basic, really. So that's more of a walkway than a road. So Lock Galley next. Well, what do we do after this route comes out? Because there's nothing else imminent, but there's so much more that has come out that we can showcase that is worth having a look at. Hoping to do a full run out of Paddington through to Heathrow using a combination of Trainsim World 4 and Trainsim Classic in the next few days, all being well. Okay, should have been keeping an eye out there. We're down to 35 miles an hour. It's quite a serious overspeed, really. Watch what you're doing. In the distance there don't look quite finished to do they? The water is that Lock Galley itself, I presume. Looks lovely. I think this little display thing there, that's supposed to be giving us information as well. Can't doubt the beauty of travelling about in Scotland, though. And it does make me want to have a journey across the Forth Bridge. Can't believe I've never done it. I've been up to the West Islands, to Fort William, to Malay, Oban. Never across the Forth Bridge.
We'll soon arrive at Lough Gelly. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
Serious overspeed this time. Might be struggling here. You'll be alright if you're on the other side. We got some of the train in the platform. Okay. Well, not sure people could really get out there. Never mind. We'll pretend that didn't happen. Certainly not starting the run again from scratch. Cardendon is our penultimate stop. Well, it's fairly early morning service. It's taking just about an hour from Edinburgh Waverley. I think it's about 45 minutes to Mark Inch on the east side. Should help a bit with the announcements too, because that's a good guide to when to start braking. I think it's a question of making sure you pour enough brake on. I'll try not to repeat what happened last time. Commented that the fields look a bit bare in places like this, but it's not exactly full of life. Yeah, there's a few examples there, it just doesn't look quite right, does it? Oddly, no announcements this time. Quite sure what's going on there. Some odd passenger movements. A few bits, I think, of some of the scenery here and there, some of the building, some of the texturing, just some of the effort overall that doesn't quite feel up to Thornton World 4 standards, but I think we'll get a fairly substantial patch. I mean, we had the same thing with Skyhook Games, and they brought out the middle and main line. It's missing things like Derby's Pride Park, and I think there was a, you know, one of those gas canister buildings in its place, and they did eventually put in things like Pride Park, and they added to it. So I think that's what will happen with this route. But for all that, it's been a thoroughly enjoyable ride. I've probably said that on every single stream I've done on any route so far. And again, massive thanks to the people who've created this patch on the Trainsim community website. Made the, I think some of the foliage is better than how it came out. They've got rid of those horrible bagpipe sounds at Edinburgh Waverley Station. The ballast looks better. And all that within days of the route coming out. There's some very talented people on the Trainsim community website. The scenery there, the foliage looking quite nice, I think. There's clearly parts of the route that are better than others, but you see some little scenes like there with the river or the loch, whatever it is, quite nice. Downhill gradient. And there are times when the lighting can still look a bit too oversaturated, and I don't know, maybe it is realistic for the time of the day, but that's why I kind of wanted to start quite early. Yeah, kind of those golden colours. Massive dense urban place for the terminated station. Feels like we're still in the middle of nowhere, really. Got the track joint sounds in. Sounds a bit tinny to me, though, not quite as good as they could be. There seems to be any hint of civilization. Going to get an announcement at our final station. We didn't at the last one. I don't know whether memory or what comes into play. Ah, no, we are getting an announcement.
We'll soon arrive at Glenrothes with Thornton. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
And here we are, our final destination, Glenrothes with Thornton. Journey's End. So that's been our very first look at this five circle route. I've enjoyed it. Hope you've enjoyed the video, and if you've liked it, then I'd be really grateful if you like it and you consider subscribing to the site as well. Keep putting up more content. Well, that's my first look at Fife Circle, and until next time, it's goodbye.